Once upon a time.
No, I better show you. Look, this is a video from 1997. You can see a newborn baby hanging for a long time, clinging to an object. The child doesn't know what's happening, but their fingers and reflexes work flawlessly. This is something we inherited from our ancestors. In ancient times, this was apparently important and necessary. If you loosen your grip, you die. But we're not the only creatures on the planet with secret abilities. Today, you'll learn where is the off button in your cat, why monkeys lose control seeing themselves in the mirror, and how to force a spider to forget how to spin his web. Time to roll. You must have seen these photos. What's going on here anyway? Have cats reached a new level and they no longer need boxes? The owners of these animals believe that if you draw a circle with chalk or make a square on the floor or depict any geometric figure on the floor, the cat immediately sits inside. You can use a towel, a wire, or even tinsel. Anyway, the cat will sit inside, as if she has nothing better to do. Okay, now let's see if this works. A cat? Check. A square? Check. Come on, sit. Hey, come on. Yeah, looks like my cat broke down. But what's the real reason for this behavior anyway? No, not the behavior of my cat, but of all cats in general. It's believed that people tamed these animals about 4,000 years ago. Yes, for 4,000 years, these creatures have been leaving fur on our clothes, ruining our favorite shoes, and chewing headphone wires. Okay, wires are a little bit more of a modern problem. During this time, people have tried to study cats, but unsuccessfully. It's well known that cats like the safety of enclosed spaces such as boxes and closets. They also like to sit on high ground, from where they can observe the area.
He's hanging up. Hold on, Willie, it's slowing down, okay?
Well, let's face it. Even scientists who specialize in cats don't have a definite answer to what's going on. But there is a lot of speculation. Most likely, it's not about the shape of figures, their location, or even the material. It's about the smell. Cats love to explore new things, and often do so with the help of smell. So for them, a circle on the floor is not a circle at all, but just a place that smells differently. And if the smell has changed, they feel like they should sit down next to it and see what happens next. However, if you know the secrets of the cat's brain, you can not only make your pet sit in the right place, you can even turn off your cat. Don't believe me? See it for yourself. Although this feline is a little bit bigger than a regular cat, its body works in a similar way. When the mother picks the little tiger up by the scruff, it paralyzes, as if there were really an off button somewhere there. Well, you know, a button to turn off the tigers. The little tiger just hangs and waits until it's lowered back to the ground. Surely you did this to your cat when it was little? Yeah. Some animals in a similar situation stop moving.
It looks a little weird, but as you can see, body gets really loose. As soon as you let go, as you can see, not painful.
Why? First of all, reflexes. The scruff was designed by nature as the handle to transport little puppies and kittens. And to make the life easier for the mother, cubs were made very obedient. Try to move something from place to place, holding it in your mouth. Now imagine it moves too. So this off button allows parents in the wild to worry less. By the way, the scruff trick works not only with puppies or kittens. This is considered a dominant action by any cat or dog, no matter their age. Therefore, if you have an adult pet, you shouldn't try to do this because it will only distress your pet. It's no coincidence that in a fight, animals try to bite each other by the scruff. It's like saying, I'm in charge here. Well, you have to do something when you can't afford a big car, because you have paws. All right, now pay attention. Don't try the following trick at home. You can turn off your cat without consequences, if you don't have a tiger at home, of course. But the following trick can certainly cost you your life, or at least a hand, or a pair of fingers, because it's an attempt to hypnotize an alligator. Strictly speaking, this is not exactly hypnosis or a trance. You just interrupt the connection between the inner ear of the animal and his brain. Doesn't hurt, it's just a small bug in nature's design. You just have to roll the crocodile on its back and hold it like this for a while. However, usually the crocodile doesn't like it, so you also need to hold the jaws. In the end, if you're lucky, the predator will be disoriented for a while, until it regains consciousness. Then you better stay away. In fact, few people can say, I love crocodiles so much, but spiders have even fewer fans. Most often, everyone tries to stay away from spiders, except NASA. They gave the poor creatures different substances and tested how they would affect their webs. And the spiders, which usually can spin a web in any situation, broke down. Some substances force them to create more symmetrical patterns, while others make the spiders forget about their duty.
A web? What web?
I'm out. But see what happens when you give spiders a drug that is sometimes used to treat insomnia in people. Yeah, the spider went to sleep. You think caffeine would cheer up the poor guy? What's good for humans makes the spider create chaotic webs. In the end, scientists gave the spiders amphetamine and finally broke it. But let's leave the spiders alone. Watching them can be a little scary after all. We'd better take a look in the mirror. Although sometimes there are really scary things there too. Especially on a Monday morning. But in general, mirrors are one of the most common items in our life, and it'd be hard to imagine our life without them. In animals, everything is different. For example, dogs, despite their intelligence, can't easily recognize their reflection. But some dolphins, elephants, and big monkeys easily cope with this really difficult task. And I'm not even kidding when I call it complicated. It takes 18 to 24 months for human babies to understand what they're seeing in the mirror.
Hi.
But the animals I mentioned can do it faster. However, some animals believe they're seeing their partner in the mirror, or an enemy. Fighting with a mirror is a common thing. There are so many reactions that it seems that they depend on each particular individual. Some animals can get so used to mirrors, they even get upset when they're unable to see their reflection. And this isn't even the mirror of Erised from Harry Potter, probably. What else can be considered an integral part of human life? For example, in the morning, you look in the mirror when you're getting ready, then go out and, let's say, sit behind the wheel. Sometimes the weather's nice outside and you just want to poke your head out the window. Feel the wind in your hair and, well, in all this, you know. But when dogs begin to do something similar, it brings up some questions. But they do it because they can. A dog's head is an incredible sensory device. You could say that it's simply packed with all kinds of sensors, like some cool modern devices. With its head out the window, the dog sniffs at everything that the car passes by. Mostly it gets attracted to the smell of food, of course, but it's also interested in people, other dogs, and all sorts of smelly things on the streets. So basically, a dog with its head sticking out the car window is a real explorer and a very, very good boy. Okay, dogs and cars look cute and funny, but what about seagulls? Well, if you see a seagull in a car, please send me a picture. I'm talking about the birds who are constantly circling near the water in search of prey. Fishing? No, that's too difficult. Why fish when you can just pick up garbage? Even better, snatch a sandwich from a distracted tourist. These insolent, gluttonous creatures who pretend to be birds, I mean seagulls, not tourists, well, seagulls adapt to the urban environment better than any other animal. They're able to see food at a distance of 50 meters and quietly snatch it right from your hands in less than a minute. Oh, just remembered, we talked a lot about cats today, but I forgot to mention one important and quite funny moment. The feline reaction to catnip. If you have a cat, you can imagine how it goes. If not, then it's something like this. It's a kind of animal alcohol that makes cats go crazy for a few minutes. They roll on the floor, lick and bite plants, purr loudly, maybe sing obscene songs in feline language. All this lasts for maybe 10 to 15 minutes, then they sober up and probably feel a little awkward. By the way, catnip affects both domestic cats and lions. So if you're being chased somewhere in the savannah, you know what to do. Researchers suspect that catnip targets the happy receptors of the cat's brain. Apparently, this has developed over the years of evolution. It happens because of essential oils. And yes, even if your pet goes crazy, this plant is considered harmless. And it's not addictive either. When the essential oils of catnip are inhaled by the cat, the hypothalamus, a special part of the brain, receives a signal. It's this organ that generates such an interesting reaction. Catnip makes some cats calmer, while others, usually males, become more aggressive. Basically, it's like alcohol. So if you suddenly want to have a glass of wine but don't have anyone nearby apart from your cat, just give it some catnip and step away. In this part of the video, I usually say something clever, remind you about the fact that we really need your likes, and we really want you to subscribe to our channel. But you already know all this. We're cool. You're cool. We're made for each other. See you later.